welcome to the 3D News Weekly Update here at 3duniverse.tv. This is podcast number one. My name is Claudia, and it's a pleasure to be here with you. So today we are going to talk about the latest news in the 3D world, like James Cameron's comments on the subject, the latest 3D movies, and some trouble concerning the 3D glasses. Okay, let's get started. So we're going to talk about James Cameron's thoughts on the 3D fever. We know that Sony, Samsung, and Panasonic are putting some major weight behind 3D TVs, so Sony executive Yoshihisa Shida predicted that 3D televisions will liberate 3D from the confines of the movie theaters. In an interview with USA Today, James Cameron, however, advised consumers to be patient. He claims the 3D market to be an extremely lucrative market and not just something that's gonna go away. He also believes 3D TVs are going to change things yet again, but TVs are going to take a while to catch up with the marketplace because there isn't enough content yet. So if you watch a 3D movie, you probably know you need to wear some funny looking glasses. Third-party glasses haven't made much news yet, but ESPN hopes to change that. Currently, all the major 3D TV manufacturers are making their own glasses, so for instance, Samsung glasses will only work in Samsung TVs. However, there's a small company called ESPN that's working on offering universal 3D glasses that will work with any set. The X103 series will be able to detect infrared signals from virtually every 3D set. ESPN intends to market the glasses as a fashion item, so they'll be available in 12 colors ranging from sizes from kids to adults. The glasses will cost $120 to $150. Unfortunately, we're not able to use the non-polarized glasses to watch 3D content on 3D TV. Just yet. Alright, so let's have a look at what's going on in the movie theater. On the box office this weekend, How to Train Your Dragon beat the comedy Hot Tub Time Machine also in its opening weekend. The 3D adventure made $43.3 million, while Alice in Wonderland came in second with $17.3 million. Alice, however, has already made $656 million worldwide in just 3 weeks. It appears 3D movies are dominating the US box office as they have led for 9 of the 13 weekends of this year. So if you're a sports fan, you may want to hear this. Sports broadcasting will enter a new dimension in 2010. The third dimension. ESPN will be the industry's first 3D network. According to George Bottomheimer, ESPN and ABC Sports president, ESPN 3D will showcase a minimum of 85 live sporting events during its first year, beginning on June 11th with the first 2010 FIFA World Cup match featuring Mexico versus South Africa. Bottomheimer is excited about mixing a great content with a new technology to enhance the fans' viewing experience. He also believes it will be the next big advance for TV viewing. You will be able to watch ESPN 3D on DirecTV and Sky. Okay, so that's it for today from this beautiful Miami Beach, Florida. I am Claudia, and remember, you can watch us in 3D by choosing the 3D version of this episode and selecting the choices of classes here below. Thank you for watching. See you next week.